Hello everyone, it's Stephen Whiteside here from theuptrend.com with this week's edition of Protect Your Portfolio. In this weekly presentation, we take a longer-term look at the North American markets using weekly charts. Now, we use weekly charts to filter out all of that market noise from Monday to Friday, so we're left with just one data point to work with, and that's the closing price from 4 p.m. Friday afternoon. Remember, price is truth and news is noise, and all we care about is that closing price. Now, today is Canada Day, so it's a national holiday here, and the markets will be closed tomorrow north of the border. Tuesday, it's a half day in the U.S. as people get ready for the July 4th holiday, which is Wednesday. And so it's going to be a fairly quiet week, and so we're going to take the next 3 days off. And the next time that we'll post new charts is going to be Thursday night. And then, of course, again on Friday, we'll do a weekly wrap-up. But this week should be a very quiet week. Now, June is historically a negative week, and we finished off the half year, the second quarter, fairly weak. So far, year-to-date, the S&P 500 is up 1.67%, while the NASDAQ is up over 10%, and the TSX is up just 0.42% on the year. Now, year to date, there's been some winners in the U.S. It's been Weight Watchers, it's been Tenet Healthcare, and then we've got Denbury Resources up over 100%. North of the border, Meg Energy, we've got TransGlobal, and Canfor are all big winners north of the border. Now, in the NASDAQ, of course, has been leading this market higher, and the big winners from the stocks that our subscribers focus on, we've got Etsy, we've got Netflix, we've got Twitter, and we've got Square, have all been the big winners on the NASDAQ in 2018. Now, last week at this time, we were looking at the VIX to close below $16.98, and it certainly did that after trading through the upper channel line during the week, got as high as $19.61 before closing back at $16.09. So for this week ahead, we're going to remain bullish on the market as long as the VIX does not close above $16.88. Let's start off looking at commodities, and copper was down again. So it's been down 3 weeks in a row sharply. And if copper is a global economic barometer, it's not heading in the right direction, and it made a new low for 2018. Now, gold continues to move lower. Our next level of support was 1250, closed at 1251. We'll have to see if that support level can hold. And then silver was down another a little over 2%. Silver, of course, is more of an industrial metal than a precious metal, and it's going in the wrong direction right now. Looking at global markets, last week at this time we were talking about the Shanghai market, which has been down all year. It continued to move lower, another 1.47%. We also talked about the Nikkei in Japan, still on a weekly buy signal last week. We traded through the lower channel line, closed lower on the week, but did not generate a weekly sell signal. Now, the Xetra DAX, or the DAX in Germany, is considered the NASDAQ of Europe, and it was down over 2% on the week, so a couple of rough weeks in a row, and we're back on a weekly sell signal. We saw selling in the FTSE in London, but of course we saw higher energy prices, which helped prop up the British market. We're still on a weekly buy signal there. Now, looking at energy, we saw a huge move higher in crude oil. And crude oil, next target, of course, is $75. $74.46 was the high on the week. That put upward pressure on gasoline prices, which we always hate. Unfortunately, we have a little sports car convertible that uses premium gas that costs a lot more to fill than our 4x4. And so we like to take that out in the summer, but unfortunately it costs a fortune to fill it up. Now, natural gas prices pulled back a little. I don't see them going too much lower considering the heat wave we're having right now, which of course is putting pressure on the utility companies to make more electricity. Looking at the markets, and I want to start off looking at U.S. banks. I don't really care about how U.S. banks perform. I just want them to go in the same direction as the rest of the market. And they haven't been doing that for a while now. And that's a divergence in the market as far as I'm concerned. And here we are. We've got the banks already on a weekly sell signal coming down to test the 2018 lows. Now, the Canadian banking sector has been outperforming the U.S. banking sector this year, but certainly there's nothing to write home about. We're actually underwater from the last buy signal. The last buy signal was here. The opening price is where you would have got in this market. and we are underwater at the moment, so nothing to write home about, getting pretty close to a weekly sell signal for the Canadian banking sector. Another area of concern, of course, has been the chip stocks, which put in a lower high recently, and now we've rolled over, down over 4% on the week, and we're now back on a weekly sell signal, and that is certainly not a good omen for the rest of the market. Of course, the bulls are looking at the fact that we've put in a higher low, while the bears are looking at the fact that we put in a lower high. So a mixed picture there, but we are back on a weekly sell signal, and that's all that matters. The S&P 500 traded down to the lower channel line last week, closed in the middle of the channel. So a close on the cash index below 2692.33 this coming Friday would give us a new weekly sell signal. The NASDAQ, which has outperformed the S&P 500 and recently made a higher high, has pulled back and closed in the channel. And the Russell 2000, which also is 2 weeks after, second week after putting in a new high, pulled back and closed at the upper channel line. So not expecting a weekly sell signal this coming Friday for either of those two indexes. Now, while crude oil was up sharply, so were the energy stocks. In Canada, up 2.4%. In the U.S., just up a little over 1% on the week. Both indexes and ETFs still on weekly buy signals. Looking at the TSX traded down to the upper channel line, closed just down 1% on the week. And of course, we had that pullback in bank stocks. Moving from stocks to bonds, the futures contract right on the edge of a new weekly buy signal, which would join the TLT and the XBB already on weekly buy signals. Last up today, let's look at the currencies and no major moves. We still have the US dollar index on a weekly buy signal traded down to the upper channel line, and the euro still on a weekly sell signal traded up to the lower channel line, closing unchanged on the week. And the possibility of a bottom in for the Canadian dollar, still on a weekly sell signal here, no major change in direction, but if you look down there, it looks like a double bottom, and that could be the start of a new up move for the Canadian dollar. Okay, folks, that is all for today's presentation. That's all for me for this week. Have a great week off. If you're taking the week off, have a great Canada Day and a July 4th. And the next time you'll hear my voice is a week from today, next Sunday. And at that time, we'll take a look at protecting your portfolio.